Hey, this is Dr. Joe Feuerstein with the MD Minute. Thanks for tuning in. And today I want to talk about a study that looks at the link between arthritis, that's osteoarthritis or wear and tear of the joints, and diabetes. So this study published on RMD Open, which is an online journal from researchers at the Sorbonne in Paris, looked at 1.2 million people from 47 different studies. And what it analyzed was the link between arthritis, the risk of arthritis, and diabetes. And so what they found is that in looking at all these over 1.2 million people, if you were diabetic, your risk of arthritis was 29%. And the same hold true if you had arthritis, your risk of developing diabetes was actually 14%. So there's clearly some kind of link between the two. So let's talk a little bit about osteoarthritis. What we know now is that there's actually different types, different reasons for wear and tear of the joints. Osteoarthritis can be because of age-related changes, which is why commonly arthritis happens in older people. It can be because of trauma. So if you bang your knee or you have some kind of surgery or fracture to the knee, you're going to develop arthritis quicker than if your knee was intact. But there's also now an association or recognition that you get arthritis connected to metabolic syndrome. So everybody argues that the reason for this is because you're going to get arthritis because you're heavy, your weight is heavy, and that will cause a wear and tear on the joints. But the problem with that theory is that what about arthritis of the hand? If you are heavy, you're not going to suddenly have a lot more weight on your hands. So that doesn't hold true. So what they actually researchers think is that the connection beyond just mechanical stress from weight is the fact that sugar is inflammatory. If your blood sugars are high, they're not just high and it's not doing anything in your body, they're actually causing chemical reactions all over your body. They're putting glucose molecules in different structures on different proteins, and that's causing inflammation, including inflammation in the joints of the hand. So now you can see how the two are connected. If an elevated blood sugar causes inflammation, it'll cause inflammation throughout the body, in the joints as well, including hands. So my take on this is that we have to not only work on blood sugar and reducing our weight, but also looking at the connection between inflammation, blood glucose, and arthritis. Dr. Joe Feuerstein with the MD Minute. Thanks for tuning in.